Episode number 175, coming to you live from Box O Studio in Hamilton, Ontario, shadow of the Great Hamilton Mountain. We like to call ourselves the blast furnace of live original music. We produce it in high numbers, high quality, high quantity. It's just getting... We work it. Ryan Cannon, I enjoy working with you every week and working with Gary Greenland. It's always a pleasure. How are you doing?
Awesome as always.
Good. And I would ask Gary, but we don't have a microphone for him yet.
Not yet.
Not yet. We will have a crowdfunding campaign to buy him a nice...
Soon, though.
Soon. We'll get a microphone. Gary, I'm sure, has something to say. But in the meantime, we're going to do what we do every week. We help answer that great question when it comes to new music and exploring and finding out something that you might like that you didn't know even existed. That's it. Who are you and why do I care? And we go to great lengths to explain who these people are and let you listen to how great they are and hear their stories and definitely start to care about live original music. It is something that feeds the soul. It is something that is good for everyone. And I am pleased as punch to have tonight's guest in, a great crew of amazing musicians. A couple guys have been in here before, and the two of you I've wanted to have in a long time. So thank you so much, Michelle Titian, for coming in and joining us on Barbershop Podcast. It's such a pleasure to have you. How you doing?
I'm doing good. Thank you so much for having me.
Well, it's my pleasure, like I said. And you've brought in your man, Tony Valsic, on drums, who's everybody's favorite drummer. And, you know, true, everyone loves Tony. And we were going to have the Tony show, but you're like, no.
Tony show. I thought this was the Tony show.
So we'll never get him off the podium if that starts to happen. And Colin Lapsey and Andrew Aldridge, fantastic players. You've been part of the music scene for a while in Hamilton, so obviously you're quite aware at how good the music is here. How long have you been doing it? What are the early days of you starting to play music?
I started singing when I was 16, and I didn't start writing music until I was mid-20s. So I think my first band... I did a lot of theater in high school, so that kind of got me, you know, on the stage and getting used to just performing. And the first band I was in was actually with my dad. He put like an R&B band together called the Groove Masters.
Nice.
And that was like Jamie Oakes on guitar, Sean O'Grady, I think, was on drums. I think the bass player was like, I don't know.
Neil.
Well, Neil, but then it was Neil, and then it was another guy, and I was pretty young back then, so I don't really remember much.
Yeah, just these old dudes who are really good.
I'm just like, whatever, I'm singing. yeah, and then my dad sang and played harp as well. It was pretty interesting.
Yeah, and so when you started writing in your 20s, was this something that there are poems and things that I liked writing, or were you like, no, I need to write songs because I'm starting to play?
Funny you ask, because I was mainly just interested in doing theater and never really, you know, had a full passion for writing, and it never really came to me naturally. And I was dating this guy at the time who was a musician. He was a singer, and he was in a band and in high school and stuff, and he wrote all his songs. And he once said to me, you just sing. You don't know what it's like to be a real artist because you don't write music. And it was almost like that drove me to be like, okay, I'll show you.
Yeah, fuck you, buddy.
I can write. And we broke up shortly after that. Yeah. But that's what drove me to like, it's almost like out of spite. I was just like, I can do this. I'm going to do this. And then so I started writing. Yeah. Funny story.
Tony, you come from a musical family. You know talent when you see it. Tell me about your earliest recollections of seeing her sing and play.
That's like back in La Luna, I think, right? Yep. Way back.
You got a nice pint.
A nice pint of beer.
That was a wicked Tuesday when Ron Elliott was running it.
And people
would get gonged, you know.
That's right.
You would seriously get gonged
if you saw Linda, right? Yeah. Him and Linda Somerville. Oh, okay. That's when I saw her.
Yeah.
Fantastic, man.
Yeah.
And then the Thursdays, she'd come out. Remember the jam nights, right? So then she'd come out once in a while too, right?
Yeah.
It was awesome.
And that's when we met.
Yeah.
And you thought, wow, she got a good, great voice, powerful, and a sweet player too. Now, Andrew, you've been on the show before, and you play with a lot of the female artists. And I always said you've got great empathy and a great skill in what you play, and is also what you don't play. Anything that kind of sticks out for you, we're like playing with Michelle or her music, is it any easier or tougher, or is it all like a day at the office for you at a certain point?
It's one of the easy ones again, because her songwriting's so good that it just, you know, I don't have to do anything.
Yeah.
I just have to stand there. But honestly, it's like her writing is so good that the songs sort of play themselves, and they just lend themselves to me. A, like, she's such a strong singer that I can sort of compliment and do stuff to compliment her voice and what she's singing melodically. But also, again, with the whole package of the song, it just, there's a plethora of little melodic ideas that can just come out and, again, compliment the song, not take over anything like that.
Yeah. So quite often, like a true singer, and this is what I've noticed, like I can sing, and there's people who sing, you know, and then there's singers where that voice is an instrument. It carries its own critical mass and weight, and it's really, truly is something that you can play off of, and it creates its own space. And when you hear a powerful voice or someone who commands their voice, it's a great thing. Was that, like, in the early days, like, natural, or did you have to kind of, like, train your voice?
I took vocal lessons for 4 years with a guy named Ed Johnson, and then switched over to a guy named Mitch Seekins, who still teaches. So I started taking vocal lessons when I was 16, and the amount that it has helped.
You'd recommend it to people?
Absolutely. Yeah. Like breathing exercises, and I do a little bit of teaching now, but I mean, I can't believe how much it's helped me.
Yeah, I hear that again and again. People overlook it and take it for granted. That either you got it or you don't have it. But every other instrument, it's not the case. You have to go and
But it's trained. It's something that you're not going to learn overnight. You know, it's something you really got to apply yourself to, and it's going to take years to get it, you know? Like, so, yeah, I'm really fortunate to have had those lessons for sure.
Right on.
For technique, you know?
And Colin, you're a pro. You've played with a lot of great people for a long time. I mean, obviously, it's a pleasure playing with Tony and have a rhythm section that kind of moves and shakes, right? You know, and I know that it's it's self-evident. You know, it's like to something that moves along, and pay more and more attention to it of late to see who takes what role in the rhythm section, who's making the bums move and who's keeping, you know, the pace and keeping the sheep in the pen, as it were. Sometimes it trades back and forth.
Yeah,
and
you have to do it together.
Yeah, because
I've always thought of everybody as a rhythm section too. Like, I don't quite subscribe to the bass player, drummer thing or rhythm guitarist. I think it's singer, it's everybody. It's the tambourine player, it's the keyboard player, whatever, because you all have to find, we're not making the time. The time in a song exists, and you either find it together or you don't. And if one person's out, then we're screwed. It doesn't matter who you are, what instrument you're on.
Right? Yeah. It doesn't have to be perfect. I mean, that's the whole thing. We all just listen, right? That's all we do. If it shifts a little bit, that's it.
Yeah.
It's a song
and
breathing.
And you're probably really honest with each other, too. Right? No, nobody gets butt hurt, and everyone's on the same page. So you're doing it for the right
Most
reasons.
Most of the time.
Most of the time. You need a little bit of it.
Depends. Sometimes a singer hires her husband as a drummer.
Oh, jeez.
You could do worse, that's for sure. All right, well, what we do here is we showcase live music. You know, the people at home are watching this this kind of music is available. You can go out and check it out on a Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday, Thursday, Friday, Saturday, Sunday. There's going to be someone who's featuring live music. If there is a pub or a restaurant or a bar or a tavern or any room that supports live music, drop in there even during the day. Tell the owner, proprietor, that you appreciate that, that that's something that brought you in there. Let them know that that is a good investment in the community. And live music is soul healing, and every week I love having it in here. Does great things for me, and always like kicking off the show with a live tune. So tell us about the first song you're gonna play tonight.
Well, we're gonna do a song called Rose Feathers.
Anything you want to tell about it, or is it self-explanatory?
Yeah, pretty much. I wrote it quite a while ago, and it was just like one of those first songs that I wrote that I was really looking to record, so it's on my album, and yeah.
All right. Well, you're going to get to hear it. You're going to get to hear it right here, right now. BarbershopPodcast.com.
It's just
The soundscapes of Michelle Titian right here at Barbershop Podcast. Instrumentation, writing yourself, do you kind of leave it to the guys to write their own parts? You just trust them that they are going to interpret, or do you have
pretty much
specific dreams that you have to kind of hammer out?
No, that would be too much of a struggle for me. It just fits. I don't really have to say anything.
Good.
Yeah.
It's nice when it comes together. And those are some of the great magic moments when musicians who've never met each other or come together at a jam, and it transcends where they start playing. And anyone who's a casual observer wouldn't believe that they'd never played that before, but they just get caught up in the stream and it's like they couldn't break themselves away from it.
Andrew and I ended up playing in LA probably quite a few years ago. And no rehearsal. With the drummer and the bass player, and
I knew the bass player, but I'd never met the drummer before.
Okay, so we didn't know the drummer, and we played the Cat Club, and we got up on stage, and it was like a half an hour set, and we had never done the tunes, and then we nailed it. It was awesome, and then we were telling people after the show, it was just like, we've never played together. And people were like, you're lying. Yeah. Well,
you made a comment while we're playing. So I just met these guys like 5 minutes ago.
And I literally did.
And everybody was like, no.
Yeah,
no,
running gag. It's like, no, seriously.
It was great.
The funny thing is, although I don't know if I should say it or not.
Say it.
Oh, okay. Well, there's two funny things that happened that night. The first funny thing that happened that night was when you went running up to a guy that you thought was the drummer on the sidewalk, and it turned out it wasn't the drummer.
Thank you. For what? Oh,
yeah.
Nothing.
No, yeah. Before the boat, you know.
Oh, my goodness.
But the other funny thing was later on in the night, because there was a bunch of different people playing that night, and later on you were really surprised at the people that were playing that after us, and you came up to me and you said, I think we were the best band tonight. And I'm like, yeah. And you were like, but this is L.A. I'm like, yeah. There's a lot of mediocrity here. Yeah. There's a lot of people here. Just if you're bad in Des Moines and you go to LA to make it, you're still bad in LA mediocre or whatever.
Yeah.
I tell you, Hamilton's got that in spades. It's crazy because, you know, I'm privy to it in and out every week to see the talent, and it's world class. It's not hyperbole. I'm not saying that because it sounds good. Time and time again, there are musicians like the Dave Raves of the world who, you know, are ambassadors and go out and come back and say, you know, dude, you know, I mean, that's great in Minneapolis, it's great in New York, but we're just as good. I mean, I said it. They always said this is a great town to have a band if you're a writer. And now the writing is, you know, great too. There's great studios. There's, you know, I think the beginning of something to help promote what we produce here on a regular basis. It seemed like it was, for a long time, it was just like a parts bin. And now someone's starting to, you know, put things together on a larger scale. And I certainly hope, if you're a casual observer, someone who maybe hasn't bought any new music in a number of years and really not sure what's out there, YouTube, it's just a great, great opportunity to explore music. You know, it's tough to make a buck on something like YouTube, but I think if you can get someone involved in the live music experience, someone who would go to a movie or someone who would do something else, who hasn't seen live music, and they go out and experience live music, just maybe 8, you know, 10 to a couple hours midweek. I'm a big believer, and it has huge therapeutic value. Mm. You know, do you find that you get miserable if you don't play music? Like, do you have to do it? Yeah.
Yes.
Big time.
I guess you guys too, right? But I mean, sometimes you probably bitch and moan a bit because you do it for a living. And there's a lot of, like, you had to drive up past Barry for a gig last night, right?
It's a very, I tell people when they ask, it must be great to do what you love all the time. And I tell them, of course it is. It's fantastic. I don't take it for granted, but it's a very special kind of torture to do something you love when you don't feel like it.
Yeah.
You know?
Yeah.
We didn't ever start sitting on our beds playing guitar, learning how to sing or write songs or anything because we wanted to make money at it.
No.
You know? It was for fun and because you love it and some part of your soul needs this as your kind of meditation because we're not into religion or actual, you know, yoga, that kind of stuff. This is what we do. We're going to feel great walking out of here because we just made some art together. But boy, if you don't feel like it, it sucks.
It's tough. Yeah. It's tough. I've been in 172 weeks, or 175 weeks, or I guarantee you that there's been lots of times where I didn't feel like it, but, you know, you strap it on, it's like anything else.
Can you play Brown Eyed Girl?
Actually, we've right been after saying no to that for Sally. So many years, it might be cool again now.
Oh my God. Yeah. No!
You know, that's a great idea. Have a band and just do nothing but the songs that every other band refuses to do anymore, right? That's
Mustang Sally!
Yeah.
We don't.
Bang, 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 bang. All right. Rock and roll, country, folk, blues, roots, whatever. It's music. It's great. I've got a record. It's a few years old now, but there's some beautiful, beautiful songs on this. This must have been a bit of a, was it a joy to do or was it torturous to do or was it a combination of the two?
I think a little bit of both. Mm. My brother produced it, so we had some challenges.
Yeah. Yep.
But you
knew how to fight, though, after all these years, right?
Yeah. But no.
That'd be red.
It
right?
would. Definitely something to be proud of. You know. Yeah, for sure.
That's great. Well, we're gonna hear four songs off of it tonight. We're gonna start with "Stolen." Anything you want to tell the people about the song "Stolen"?
Bill Dylan plays on this, and it's a lot of Bill Dylan and his genius ideas. Genius. Yeah.
Love Bill Dylan.
Yep.
All right. Check out his Barbershop podcast episode. You learn a thing or two about people cool. on that. Yeah, he came in, sat right here. We didn't play nothing, but he talked for a couple hours, and it was really great.
Cool.
And wonderful, wonderful stories. You know, and we pulled something. He played in Seville, Spain at this festival. He played with Roger McGuinn because he was there with Robbie, and then he's like, the guys from the Birds are here, and he just sat beside the amp and started playing and hoped they didn't kick him off, and he'd never seen it. It was 1992, and I go, well, we got the internet now, you know. It's like, you know, I found it. So he sat there for the first time, you know, saw himself playing with all these heavyweights, right? He was just thrilled. And it was thrilling for me, you know, to realize here it is 2016, you know, 15 at the time, and he'd never seen it. So
that's cool.
Yeah, magic little moments here. All right, well, here's a song called Stolen. It is off the self-titled album, Michelle Titian, and you'll be able to see where you can get it here on barbershoppodcast.com. We will get a link to that, and you're going to hear it right now, barbershoppodcast.com.
Small town where no one would go. Shared the secret with all of the ones that were close. Half his life he spent searching for I
For the things that are stolen from the self-titled album from Michelle Titian. I want to give a shout out to our great sponsor at hamiltonartist.ca. They are printers. They print stuff on stuff, or in fact, they print anything on anything. They're at 1141 Main Street East at Balmoral. That's just east of the Delta. They're committed to helping small businesses, artists, and musicians promote and market their business. They do t-shirts, mugs, buttons, anything big, anything small. They set up your artist account where your fans can go seek you out and purchase anything from the tiniest little button to a vinyl wrap of your car with your own face on it, if that's what you want. The creativity and the flexibility is great. They've got a machine where they can etch things now, right? So you can bring your acoustic guitar in there and you can get an etching just with a laser. Again, any design that you want. So it really is cool what they do there. I want to go in and get a nudie suit made or something like that, something in my size. See if they'll do that, bedazzle the hell out of it. All right, they got jewelry, engraving, all kinds of great things. Check them out, 1141 Main Street East, that's hamiltonartist.ca. All right, we've got Michelle Titian in Barbershop Podcast today and brought along a smoking band. They are Toit as a Tiger, and it's going to be our pleasure to hear another live one. What do you got for us next?
The song's called A Little Bit of Love.
A Little Bit of Love. Well, you're going to hear it. You're going to hear it right here. You're going to hear it right now at barbershoppodcast.com.
tragedy hit like a brick for the second time to you. I got the call, the one that we all fear. With father in your arms, you told me what I didn't want to hear. You run without a question. Were you thinking when I fell? In this distance you call love, bullets till I kick and shout. I feel a little bit of love and a whole lot of emptiness. I can't take back what I've done, so I'll roll with the punches. Will we make it through?
Michelle Titian right here, a Barbershop Podcast. Got any upcoming events on the horizon? Doesn't matter how far, because you're going to be on the internet forever.
Right. March?
Last Thursday in March.
At the Cat and Fiddle.
The 24th or the one after that?
31st, right? I think.
31st.
Yeah.
Right at the end of March.
Mm-hmm.
Go check it out. Cat and Fiddle, great place in Hamilton at the corner of Augusta and John Street. They feature live music, and they support live music, and it sounds great in there, and the damn chicken wings are good. I always have a good time.
Yeah,
I always have a good time there at the Cat and Fiddle. And as I said, do your bit to support what you love. And we love live music. Is there, like, someone, I'm going to ask all of you, let's start with you, Colin. Is there someone that you've kind of got a bit of an earworm for right now that you've got on your playlist, or you stumbled across that you think, wow, man, this is really neat. I'd like to share it with some other people.
I've gone full circle now since you asked. It's nothing new and classy right now, and I've never been like a one to have the energy to keep up. So I'll have people like you say, hey, if you check this out, I'll go check it out. It'll be great. Right now, I'm helping a theater company in Ancaster with a review show. So it's a big Vegas thing. So I'm music directing for that. And I've rediscovered Frank Sinatra, which is fantastic to me. It's pop and jazz. It's everything at the same time. And the best players on the planet at the time, which it's very cool. And that's where I started. It was listening to Daddy's records when I was a little kid that got me pumped. And that's what was on. You know?
Cool. I love when that kind of stuff happens. How about you, Andrew? I know you come across a lot of different music, and you're pretty open-minded, you know. So what's kind of stuck in your ear right now?
Sort of with Colin, where it's nothing new, although I'll get a lot of recommendations from people, especially Tony. He'll often say, have you heard these guys from Sweden, or have you heard this or that? And he's more on the cutting edge of the new stuff. But I was thinking about when Colin was answering, and I'm like, the things I've been listening to the most recently has actually been really cheesy early 80s pop rock.
Yeah. Amen.
But obscure things. Like one of my favorite albums from that genre things is by a band called Riggs, which they had one record produced by Andy Johns, and then nothing. But they were on the heavy metal soundtrack. You know, the big things were happening, and then they just fell off, nothing. But that sort of thing, that's what I've been listening to recently.
That's great. And it's like food. People go through, you know, you go through phases where it's like you can't get enough of something, and then you wake up one day and go, all right, you know, I'm going to move on from there. And I'm looking forward. I'm setting up a – I haven't had a proper stereo in years. You just kind of find yourself where you start listening to this and you know, our $150 sound surround with little square speakers. And it's like, you know, I got all the parts. I'm missing a couple. I got to do it. I got vinyl. I've got tapes. I've got stuff I would just love to – to listen to, you know. So I'm looking forward to revisiting some stuff that I haven't pulled out in a while. And I know I bought a couple collections from college stations and things, but, you know, they're just like, ah, we're never going to play vinyl anymore. So there's even stuff I've owned for years that I've never listened to. So I think it's good to kind of go down that rabbit hole sometimes. How about you?
Yeah,
you,
I'm trying to think of what I was listening to the other day. I actually put on Kate Bush, Hounds of Love. And I haven't listened to that album in so long. I mean, my late teens, I was just like so in awe and so in love with Kate Bush. Like all of her albums, I could not get enough of her. She's just so creative and eccentric and beautiful, you know?
Yeah, and in a world where everyone sounds like everyone, she didn't sound like anyone, right?
Hands down, one of my favorites.
Yeah.
Tony's always got an ear for new tunes and new music with a new girl. I don't think she's new, but new to us. Her name's Anna Turnheim. She's a Swedish.
Yeah.
Swedish, amazing. Yeah. Like, just like, he's like, we got to be doing that.
She's so similar. Yeah. Like, seriously, with the setup we have right there, it's really scary how cool. Yeah. And it's all singer-songwriter stuff.
But nice.
I think the Nordics, man, the Scandinavians are killing it right now.
Yeah.
I really do. They've just got, and I don't think, well, we don't get it enough. I mean, we do. You got to search for all that great music, but you got to do your homework a bit. But what's going on today is mind-blowing. Because all the references, the mics are out there, the producing's out there. You can replicate what you want, but the songwriting's everything, right?
Yeah, that's where it's.
So they're getting all that mixture coming in. I think it's really cool right now.
Awesome. You know what I think is really cool is playing another tune off of the CD. Take My Hand. Take My Hand.
Yeah, I guess that's a song about coming from a broken home, parents splitting, and just kind of figuring out at a young age how to process that and deal with that and accept it. Yeah.
Yeah. The big things and the little things, that's what I love about songwriting and music. It's, you know, it's really such a great vehicle to get stories that are universal, personal yet universal, across in such a nice way. And you're going to hear it. Take My Hand at barbershoppodcast.com.
From your eyes and quit your crying. Your papa's coming home soon. Reminds me of the good old days before it all started. He'd hold me close to his heart. Take my
fade out. Take My Hand from Michelle Titian, tonight's guest here on Barbershop Podcast. You can check her out on the YouTube. Just put it in there and find it. Glad you found us, Barbershop Podcast. We broadcast or stream every Wednesday night on Twitch TV. And you can also find us on YouTube, iTunes, just anywhere on the internet. Three words, Barbershop Podcast. Tonight's guest, Michelle Titian, coming in here with Tony Valsic, Andrew Aldridge, and Colin Lapsley. Amazingly tight, rhythmic, tuneful band. And they're going to give us another live song. What are you going to play for us now?
I'm going to play a song called Tangled Up.
Tangled Up. All right. Right here, right now. BarbershopPodcast.com.
Thank you.
absolutely beautiful. Be looking for one of these tunes on a future edition of Barber's Cuts. I'm going in there and I'm cutting out 3-4 minute songs. None of my spielage or anything like that. Just pure music. There's 19 up there. I haven't done any in a week or so. But I will. I'll get around to it. Sit down and take care of that. And another thing I got to take care of is get my numbers together. Heather's been so good for me. She's my tax lady. It's tax time. And I've got the tax person for you because she does musician taxes. She is... That's what she does. She's used to dealing with the flakes that we are, as well as if, you know, you're kind of normal person. But, you know, if you're a musician, you probably have all kinds of receipts pulled out here and there and everywhere. Well, find out what you are entitled to and make sure you get it done and for the right price. Don't go taking it to H&R Block or someplace in a mall and getting taken. You're going to get your taxes. Get your taxes done right. Fully prepared for professional tax returns, year-round bookkeeping available, no charge to e-file it. Only $25 return. If it's over $500, it's 5%. You get an extra discount if you're a barbershop podcast guest or Box O client. $5 off the $25. So it's cheap, $20 then. You can't go wrong. And guaranteed, it'd be nice when you get those GST checks and they come in and you're entitled to those. And if you've got a business, if you're a musician, you'd be surprised what you're entitled to, especially if you put everything in a shoebox. Check it out. And taxes done right. All right. Michelle Titian is in here with her smoking band, and they are really, really, really good. We're listening to some tunes off of her CD. And kind of going live with some live music. We're going to go back to the CD and we're going to talk about the song Loving You. I guess it's kind of self-explanatory, eh? Or has it got a little curveball in it?
Not really. That's just it's a lot of Bill Dylan again. Yeah. Yeah, a lot of finger-picky, really beautiful, beautiful stuff, yeah.
Well, here we go. It's an oral soundscape. That's A-U-R-A-L from Michelle Titian with some Bill Dylan on it here at barbershoppodcast.com.
Catch your last train back to Memphis. I'm still thinking about you. 2 years have gone by since we made some breathing room. Seemed as though I was searching for a different avenue. Well, this wayward heart that lies within me is storm blind without you. And I don't understand why it had to be that way. All my fault.
Such a lovely song. Loving You from Michelle Titian. And the great guitar work of Mr. Bill Dylan. Got some great talent here in Hamilton. I want you all to support it. I want you all to embrace it and wrap your arms around it and tell everyone about it, but how much it means to you. And if it doesn't, then you need to go out and experience it, because I guarantee it will. You're going to fall in love with someone. You're going to make them your personal project. You're going to share that with people and say, you know what? If you like Adele, or you like this, or you like that, check this out. And people just don't realize that there's real, legitimate, awesome, world-quality, world-class talent at their fingertips. But we change that every week. Going to get another little piece of it right now. What are you going to play for us?
I'm going to play a song called Going, Going, Gone. And it was actually a song that I did co-write with Steve Strongman.
Nice.
Yeah.
We love Mr. Steve Strongman. All right, we're going to hear it right here, right now, barbershoppodcast.com.
My lips are gone.
God damn it. So professional. I love it. It is a tight band. It is a great sound, great singing. That's the real deal right there. And you can get a sample of it on her CD. They can get that on your website,
iTunes,
I guess. They can, you know, and then we're going to have the link right there, Barbershop Podcast, as we do every week with everyone. Everyone can be found. It's not a hard deal with the internet these days. You put in, even if you don't spell it right, you'll find it eventually. But you got to try, and it's worth it. So worth it. We're going to spin one last tune off the CD before we say goodbye and promise to see you again. And the song itself is Promise.
Cool. Thank you very much for having
us. Oh, I love it. It was such a good episode. Well, we're just going to play it right here. Promise on barbershoppodcast.com.
Such a fool, maybe I'll never know. It feels like I lost everything when I let you go. I want what's good for you, even though it hurts. You are gone. Is worse. Promise me that you'd come back in the end. Want you to know that the only thing I'm thinking of is you. When the sun is sinking, I'll be of my heart. Promised me that you'd come back in the end. I want you to know that the only thing I'm thinking of is you. When the sun I'll be here waiting for you.
absolutely beautiful. Beautiful music, beautiful people. Michelle Titian, thank you so much for coming in and bringing your crew, your wrecking crew. Tony Velsic, fantastic. Andrew, always a pleasure. Great. And Colin, professional, gentlemanly, just and beautiful. Like, everyone's so damn beautiful in this band. As is my good pal, Ryan Cannon, and Gary Greenland, doing such a great job bringing the music to you, sounding so good every week, looking so good every week. Come check us out next week. It should be April. I like the sounds of that. Thanks for coming out. BarbershopPodcast.com.